my wife Janet, my son Jory, my daughter JC that Peter introduced, been so supportive of me in this journey to get to this goal that I have of being a collegiate football coach. And I just think this place is such a good fit for us for so many reasons. And so I want to extend a huge thank you to them. I've got some lifelong friends that are here today that have supported me along this journey, so I appreciate that. My dad passed away a few years ago. He would have been 69 years old yesterday. And I know he's looking down right now, and I know he's proud of me. And so that's special to me, and I want to extend that, make sure that there's no misconception that I can get here alone. I was standing on the shoulders of some really wonderful people. I want to thank President Cruzado and Peter Fields and the members of the committee for allowing me to have this opportunity. I promise you I won't let you down. The high standards of personal conduct and academic success that have been established at this university are going to continue. That's going to be the number one objective I have is to recruit and retain the student athletes that are here and make sure that they get a degree from a great institution like Montana State. So I'm proud to be the head coach here. As I mentioned, those foundations and things that have been done here with the hard work that Coach Ash and his staff has done, we're going to continue that hard work. And I think that's something I take a lot of pride in. The most important thing to me as the head football coach here are the players. It's not any one coach, any administrator, any building that represents the player, the program. The players are the program. And that was my message to them last night. Before we did any media, before we did anything else, I made sure that I had the opportunity to stand in front of them so they knew who was leading the program moving forward. I think they got a very good impression of what type of head coach I'm going to be, the type of energy, the type of work ethic that I'm going to bring to the table, and what my expectations are going to be from them as student athletes here at Montana State. My job is to recruit and connect to them. They have to want to play for me and the young men and the other coaches that I bring here. And I think that's always been a strength of mine as a coach. I think these guys are going to have a tremendous experience playing football here. And the beautiful thing about coaching at the FCS level is that there's some perspective. I've been to some great places, but we ask an awful lot of these guys as student athletes. And here at Montana State, we can really keep the student first. And then they can have a college experience that they're going to look back on years from now. And it's not just going to be the things they did. You know, when they look back on it 15 years, it's not going to be the things that they did here. It's not going to be the final score that they're going to remember. You know, the thing that they're going to remember is who they become as a result of this experience. And that's going to be a big deal to me and our staff. Now, the one thing they will remember is they'll always remember that game against the team over the hill. And so we got to make sure that we own this state and do everything we can to make sure that the Montana State University has its rightful place in this state. And I promise you, I understand that rivalry, and I respect it tremendously, and I'm excited to be a part of it in the near future. I want to just kind of give you a little bit of an overview. If you ever want to have your life turned upside down, take a head football job. It's been a really interesting experience. I'll tell you about it someday. Some of the things that I'm in the process of doing right now is meeting with the current players, encouraging them to finish strong in the classroom. One of the things that I let them know is my first evaluation of you is going to be when I get the grade report, know how you did on your finals. We're going to be all about finishing things around here, and that's the expectation. And so I'm going to meet with each one of these young men face-to-face before they get out of here for Christmas break. Want them to tell me their story, what their major is, what the things that they love about Montana State are. And then obviously I'm in the process of evaluating the current staff and formulating the staff moving forward. I think that's really important. The off-season program is going to be of utmost importance to us. And then also finalizing our 2016 recruiting class. In closing, and then we'll take some questions from the media, I just want to reiterate a couple of things. Number one, I didn't get here by myself. I've had so many coaches along my journey that have assisted me and helped me. Two of my greatest mentors are men that have coached here at Montana State, Mick Denny and Mick Delaney. I would be remiss if I didn't mention those two men and how important they've been in my life. Chris Peterson and the time that I spent with him at Boise State, really learned a ton from him. And those are three people that have really had a strong influence on my coaching background. Lastly, you know, I'm sure people are going to ask me what this is going to be about. And I think about it like this. You know, I think it's about character, accountability, and toughness. And that's what this program is going to be about. We're going to recruit high-character young men. We're going to represent this university in a first-class fashion. We're going to make sure that they understand what it means to be accountable to each other, to this program, and to themselves. And we're going to put a heck of a good, tough brand of football on the field. We're going to play some defense. We're going to have explosive offense. And we'll get after other teams as well. I appreciate y'all being here today. Happy to take some media questions at this time. Go Cats.
Hey, Coach, Greg Rockash from the Gazette in Billings. Maybe you can just talk logistically how this is going to work, because I know Washington has a bowl game coming up on the 26th, I think. What's going to be your plan going forward the next 3 weeks or so?
Yeah. So as we move forward, this week is the last week of a contact period. And as I mentioned before, I could have come in here and done this press conference and left and hit the road. My most important recruiting job are the young men that are here. And so I want to make sure that I get the opportunity to meet with them. When that's done, we're going to prioritize the in-state Montana commits. I should be able to get to most of those young men through the remainder of the week. At that point, basically it would be a recruiting weekend starting on Friday. So I'm gonna travel back to Seattle, and I will coach the bowl game with Boise State. And so we'll have practice on Saturday and Sunday. I'll be working the phones, putting my staff together, communicating with the recruits that we have committed to us and ones that we're trying to convince to come to Montana State, as well as doing all kinds of a million other things that I'm sure you can appreciate. But as we move forward, it's dead on Sunday night, and so all I can do is phone recruit anyway. So I'll be able to go to, you know, do that during my time in preparation, helping Huskies get ready for their bowl game. It was an honor to be asked to do that, and so I'm looking forward to having one last opportunity to coach the young men there. And then as we get to around the first of the year, we'll kind of hunker down here. I'll have my staff set. We'll get one day Bozeman and bury ourselves in the bunker and figure out what the first 90 days of this thing's going to look like.
Coach, what do you think the most important thing is you bring to this program?
I think energy, integrity, and ability to connect with players are the three things that I would say. I'm always going to be honest, 100% honest with them. I'm going to hold them to a high standard. But I think the energy and the ability to connect with these kids is one thing that is going to really help me in this first 90 days in establishing the type of program that I'm going to have here.
Coach Coulter, Lawrence Skyline Sports. Can you talk about just the process of this whole thing? When did this first land on your radar, and how fast it all happened? Can you just talk about that and
what
this has been like for you?
It was fast. Once the job was open, it was trying to find a way to gain traction. You know, this is a place that I've been very interested in for a while, and really respected the job that Coach Ash and his staff had done here, and knew that this was a good place for a number of reasons. Number one, This is a tier one Carnegie institution. I mean, that's totally different than anybody else we're recruiting against in the Big Sky. And we have a tremendous product to sell to these young men here. And so I was excited about that part of it. But, long story short, it's always about who you know, right? And so I had to find a way to get Peter Fields and members of the committee to know who I was. And good thing there's the Montana hotline. I got a bunch of friends around the state. My time at Western, those connections have paid off for me a little bit. And so I actually dropped my wife and my daughter off at the Nutcracker in Seattle on Sunday night, and Jory and I were going back to watch the Sunday night football game. My phone rings about 6:30, and Mr. Fields, and he says, hey, would you like to come in tomorrow for an interview? Tomorrow. And the best thing could happen to me. I didn't have to think about anything. I didn't have to stress about anything. I just got on the plane and went and did it. And then for the rest of the week, I wasn't worried about it either, because I was traveling around the country recruiting for the Dogs. So that was kind of how it went down.
What do you think your connections here in Montana will do for you to help with this program?
Well, I think one of the unique things about Western when I was there was that, you know, probably 90% of the guys that I played with ended up going into education. Most of them were teachers and coaches and are still involved in public education throughout the state, whether they're superintendents or head high school coaches. And so they're going to be guys that are going to be able to give me really good information about the character of the young men that we're recruiting. They're also going to be able to tell those kids what kind of coach they're going to get. And I think that those lifelong connections, that means something in Montana. A handshake means something, looking somebody in the eye, being one of them. I think I am one of them. And I'm not going to lose sight of that. I think that's going to be tremendously important and helpful for us in terms of making the types of strides in recruiting that we want to in the state.
What's your plan for hiring assistants, and will you be retaining any of the current assistants that we have on staff?
Yeah, his question was, what is my plan for my staff, and am I going to retain any current assistants? And so, as I mentioned a moment ago, I'm in the process of evaluating the current staff. It's been less than 48 hours, and so that's something that, as you know, we'll inform our players and move forward in that direction. As we know, I'm in the process of evaluating those guys, and I would anticipate that there will be some that will be retained, and just got to make sure it's the right fit for us. And I promise you this, we'll have a first-class group of men coaching these boys.
Coach Sean McShelton with ABC Fox Montana. You touched on Montana State had been on your radar for a little bit. Why was it a good fit, and why was this a job that you wanted to go after?
Well, I think this, number one, I'm a Big Sky guy. I mean, I've coached in the SEC. I've coached in the Pac-12 a couple different times. I've been on the big stage, and I enjoyed it. It was awesome. But at the end of the day, when I really looked at it, I was like, where do I want to be a head coach? This is the level, and a lot of it has to do with my time at Eastern Illinois in the FCS level. I was there for a year, and I really kind of got that this is different than the FBS level. These kids can have a college experience. I can let them do travel abroad. We can work around class schedules. It's what college football was supposed to be, and it's gotten out of hand. And so that's one of the things that really attracted me. The academic profile of this place was very attractive to me because I know the caliber of young men that I can recruit. I think that I love Montana, deep roots here, and Bozeman's a pretty awesome town. So I think all those things kind of came together for me, and I feel very, very fortunate to be here.
What do you think of the status of the program you're inheriting here?
I'd say this, it's not broke. You know, might need to go in for a tune-up, and sometimes all it is just an influx of energy and a little different approach. As I mentioned, I have a tremendous amount of respect for Coach Ash and his staff and the work that they've done here. It speaks for itself, really. And so I'm not in here to do anything but praise them and build on what they've done and try to help this place go to the next step.
Coach, what can you say will be your expectations or in your demands of your players?
We'll have a standard in everything we do, and the standard is the standard. That's it. There's no excuses, no complaining, no defending your actions. You know, we either get it done or we don't. And that starts with me and the assistants that I bring in here. And so I'm going to have just as high expectation, if not higher, for myself and my coaches than I am for these players. If we lead them the correct way, they'll follow. And so we're going to have really high standards, and they're going to be really hard to attain. But we'll be fine. I mean, it's going to be grueling in terms of the mental energy that we've got to put in it, in terms of preparation, because it's not going to be that everything that we do is going to be calculated, and it's going to be done with all of us together, so that when the linebacker coach goes into the linebacker room, he was a part of what we decided we were going to be about here, and he's going to be able to convey that message to our players, and they'll buy in quickly. I think they'll feel the urgency from the head coach all the way down, and I wish we'd go out there right now, to be honest with you, but we'll have to wait a few months for that.
You mentioned Coach Delaney, Coach Denny. Can you expand on that a little bit, just what sort of influence those guys have had on you and how that kind of led you to this point?
Yeah, well, one of the things that I really believe is that, my objective here is to build a team to win. That's what I need to do, okay? But in a bigger picture, I need to build these people, these young men, for their life. And that's what Nick and Nick did for me. They turned me in from a boy to a man, gave me tough love. Nick Delaney, I learned how to treat people. You show me somebody in the state that doesn't like him or respect him, there's probably something wrong with them. Nick Denny, all about toughness and connecting to players and just two really influential good people in my life.
Recruiting wise, what's going to be the strategy immediately, and also where's what's going to be kind of the scope of it all? Where are you guys targeting just regionally and things like that?
So I think the Big Sky, the footprint of the Big Sky is expanded tremendously as the league has expanded, but we can't lose sight of that. We got to win our backyard. We're ultimately going to win championships with Montana kids that grew up went to be, wanted to be Bobcats, understand the history and tradition of this proud program. When we bring people in from out of state, they're going to be able to explain to them what it means to be part of this program. And that's tremendously important to me, first and foremost, on the state. We'll expand it in population bases in the Northwest. You know, anything within a 10, 12 hour drive of here where people can get in a car and be here and come here unofficially on visits and visit here as they're going through Yellowstone and you know, stop by and see what Montana State has to offer. I think that's important. So that would include, you know, the Boise area, the Spokane area, the I-5 corridor in Western Washington where I have strong ties. And then I've recruited primarily the Houston area, but in the state of Texas extensively for the last 12 years. And so I think that's something that there's been a lot of inroads made here at MSU. And I think we'll continue to reap those benefits because of the connections that I've made there as well.
Coach, what pressures will you be under here at Montana State, not just on the football field, but academically as well?
Well, I think everything that we do starts with recruiting, right? And so we've got to be very diligent and do our homework on the young men that we bring here. Their degree, that piece of paper at the end of the day needs to be more important to them and their family than it is to me. Because if I've got to run them around and take them to class, there's going to be a disconnect. And so that's going to be, and a short answer is, I have to recruit top-notch young men who are all about getting their degree that are really good football players.
Coach, you mentioned the rivalry with Montana. There's a real hunger here to be more competitive and to beat Montana more. What is your approach to that, and how do you kind of see how that's going to be done, I guess?
Well, we're not going to beat Montana one day a year. We're going to beat Montana every day. And we've got to go out there and prepare for you know, our first game's against the University of Idaho in Moscow, Idaho, I believe. Is that correct? Okay, that's going home for me. I'm going to have a chip on my shoulder, and I'll make sure those guys are prepared to go. And then we'll take it one game at a time. And if the mojo is right, when we get to the Brawl of the Wild, it'll take care of itself. But we can't be consumed or obsessed with winning that one game. We're about winning championships here. And, you know, at the end of the day, I hope these guys, when this thing's all said and done, we're beating them because they're on our schedule, not because they're somebody, that there's something that's bigger than they are.
The players under Coach Ash, how will you gain their respect? They lost a great coach.
I totally agree with that, and I think that how I'm going to do that is I'm going to gain their trust. You know, it's about showing them who I am. It's about reaching out and connecting to them, showing them I care about them, taking the time to get to know them, holding them to high standards. I think they'll respect that. And it's not going to happen overnight, and it doesn't have to, because I'm going to be here for a while. And so they'll get the message, and I think that they.